Welcome again. Today we are talking to Ryan Long about stewardship not of finances specifically, but of all the gifts that God gives us in this Life at All Saints video series, Living in Faith Every Day. Ryan, thank you for being on camera, for hanging out on what has been a busy Sunday for you anyway. And that's kind of why I wanted to interview you, because you're very involved in so many ways at All Saints, and I don't think that beyond maybe your wife and kids, I don't know that people know how involved you are. Pastor Bonnie and I know, and we value your involvement, so I wanted to talk about that a little bit today. But I'd like to begin, Ryan, with asking you just how long you've been a member at All Saints, and how long you've been attending here.
Yeah, so we've been a member of All Saints for about 15 years. We spent 7 years out in Southern California.
Okay.
And then upon moving back here with our newborn son, we joined All Saints.
Good deal. Okay. So then I want to get to the next step of that. You've been very active at All Saints in a lot of ways. Counsel, anything we need, unloading pumpkins out of a truck, serving at the pumpkin patch, helping today to load up quilts. I'd like, though, from you to tell me what, some of the things that have stood out to you that you've been involved with here, and what's been meaningful to you.
Yeah, council's been a great opportunity for me to help have the privilege to serve on the council, and it's really given me some insight to the ministry that All Saints provides, way over and above the things that I've been involved in. So, and some of my favorites over the years with All Saints have been the trips with the youth. Mm-hmm. Right? The mission trip this summer was fantastic.
Yeah, you went to Westfield with all the Indiana with the youth. And
yep, both of my kids got a chance to go, and it was fantastic.
Awesome. Talk about a little bit about that, what you did there in Westfield, and what you saw, what you observed, what stood out to you that was meaningful.
Yeah, it was really a nice opportunity. We had a great crew that I worked with every single day, and I brought a ton of power tools with me. So I was a little nervous that we had to be really safe with all the tools.
Yeah.
And everybody was great. Everybody did a really nice job. Mm-hmm. We got to our job site, and they had a couple small projects. This family had a deck on the back of their house, and it was in really rough shape. The stairs were gone. There were two sets of stairs that were in the grass. They had fallen off.
Yeah.
And there were some spots that you basically could fall through if you weren't careful. Mm-hmm. And so we got there, we looked at it, and we had an opportunity to do a lot more than what was on the list when we looked at the project, but we need a ton more material. And as part of our initial evaluation, the coordinator came out and walked us through the project, and we said, hey, we want to take on a lot more. So he was able to get us a ton more material, and we resurfaced the entire deck, put new stairs on both sides of it, and a railing clear around it. So we had a great opportunity to
You kind of had like a job superintendent, if you will, that kind of guided, because, I would think for me, like maybe many of the youth, you go and you say, well, I don't know anything about building steps on a deck, but it sounds like the kids just, they had a job, they were explained how to do it, and they just stepped up and did it.
They did, they stepped up, and it was hot some days, it rained on us one day, but I was determined that we'd get the job done, and it worked out really well.
Yeah, you had a week, and you did it.
Yeah, we got it done.
Great, thank you. So I'd also like to talk about again, you give a lot of time here, and I know that, and that's why I wanted to talk to you today about it. But how does this giving of time and talent, how does it deepen your faith?
It really, when I think back to my youth and growing up in a Lutheran church, there were some adult leaders that did a fantastic job. We did similar mission trips.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, we worked with Habitat for Humanity,
right.
And they really did a nice job of helping to lead those trips and help me learn a lot about service.
So they kind of modeled, maybe, I don't know if they meant to, but something about that, stuck in your mind that this is what I need to do when
Absolutely.
I'm an adult. Yeah.
Yeah, and it was fantastic. And it set me up to try to lead by example as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, you do a wonderful job of that. I think about all the times that we've knew that we've needed to call people. We've either needed to move furniture, or we needed to, again, unload pumpkins off a truck, or something needed to be set up, and Ryan Long is always on that list of people to call, and so we value that so much. Ryan, I'd like to talk, too, about finances a little bit. It's something I'm not trying to focus on too much in these videos, but financial giving, I think, is a part of how we give and support ministry. So I'd like you to maybe, if you could, speak to that, why you and your family make a financial commitment to All Saints, why that is important to you and to your faith.
It really, our situation has been really, really strong over the last, ever since my wife and I have been married. We've had great jobs. We've had a lot of blessings, a lot of resources through our employment. Mm-hmm. And I'm having the opportunity to contribute mm-hmm. to all the ministry at All Saints mm-hmm. and be a small part mm-hmm. of the mission at All Saints has been fantastic. We actually did Dave Ramsey here at All Saints as well.
Mm. I've taken that class too.
Have you really?
FPU, yeah.
Yeah, we did financial peace with Jenna and Mark Fisher here at the church.
Okay.
And it's been a long time ago. It was in 2009, mm-hmm. but they did a fantastic job with the class.
Wow.
And we really dug in, and I sold my Harley as a part of the class. And so that was a tough day, but it took 7 years, but we paid everything off.
That's amazing. That's a whole other conversation that we could have. But my wife and I in 2008 took Financial Peace University in Indiana, and it really, like you're kind of speaking of, it helped us to make a budget and to look at everything that came in, all the income, and then where it all goes. And as you know, Dave Ramsey makes you write it all out, like every penny has to be accounted for. But I found when you do that, the blessing in that is that you know what you can give. Before, I was like guessing at like, how much can I spend on this birthday gift for, you know, a family member or a friend? But when you see it on paper, you know what you can give away. And so I do feel that also helped my tithing to be intentional. And you don't feel as much like you're guessing at what you can give, but it becomes a meaningful way you know, that maybe you might be able to give more than you thought. So that's very cool that you all took FPU, and that it sounds like it had a real profound impact, not only in getting out of debt, but just how you look at money and giving in general.
Yeah, it definitely changed your life, and it's been fantastic.
Yeah, for my family too. So I'm going to kind of wrap up, Ryan, with a question about what, just in general, why you believe it's important to give back to your community, to the church, in anything in life. Why do you feel it's important to be one of those people that doesn't just sit home and let someone else do it, but why is it important to step up and give back?
Really, it's been a blessing for us and a great opportunity to serve. And I spend a lot of time as a servant leader at work, mm-hmm. and the time spent with the youth has been fantastic. Mm-hmm. And I think that's a big part of what drives me as well, is I'm being a part of the youth ministry mm-hmm. and helping the youth to understand service and how you can contribute mm-hmm. to the congregation, to the community, and even outside of the local community here.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Ryan, I want to thank you again for all that you do for All Saints, for your family, for the community, and beyond. So, and especially what you give to God in all that you do. So thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Scott.